overall good news, but we were just talking about the new proposed juvenile center, and juvenile crime is up a little bit. Your thoughts on why that is and what we need to do in that area specifically?
Well, yes. First of all, the good news is that overall violent crime is down.
Right.
Was down in 2018 compared to 2017. Gun crimes in particular were down by over 15%.
Yes.
40 gun crimes.
Well, let's talk specifically first about the juvenile.
The bad news would be that violent crime charges against juveniles were up in 2018 compared to 2017 by about 8 to 9%.
Right.
That is disturbing. Sheriff Bonner probably has a better feel for why. There are a lot of theories about that. One is the increase in car break-ins mm-hmm. and car thefts, and juveniles may be involved in that. There may be some other reasons as well. But overall, we need to be encouraged by the 2018 figures, mm-hmm. but we also need to really be paying attention to that spike in violent juvenile crime.
Well,
all right,
so
with that in mind, Sheriff, where do you stand on this? Is there a reason to be alarmed by some of these numbers, especially involving juveniles?
Well, anytime it's involving juveniles, Alex, we're alarmed. We've been talking about the Juvenile Assessment Center here in Memphis, getting that open out at UT Health Center. And we're looking at it. We look at our data smart policing every week and look at crimes. And thefts from motor vehicles is what's driving our numbers out in the county. When you look at thefts from motor vehicles because of people leaving guns, weapons, computers, all sorts of things in their cars, and juveniles are just out at night pulling on car doors.
Right, and that may be a starter crime.
Yeah, sort of. Right.
And can we learn some things from what we've done to reduce gun crime overall and overall crime that maybe we can extrapolate to the juvenile population particularly?
Well, I think you're right on point there, Mayor Belt. And I think one of the things that will help us here in Shelby County is the Juvenile Assessment Center. When kids start at these low-level crimes, we have a place to take them and get them assessed and get them maybe the help, the treatment, these kids experiencing trauma, and get them the help that they so desperately need to keep them out of that juvenile court pipeline.
So obviously, Bill, the assessment center has helped tremendously, but what about this new proposed detention center? Can they go hand in hand? Have you had a chance to kind of look into that?
Well, they do go hand in hand, and we've not been at the Crime Commission involved directly in the discussions about the detention center. We mm-hmm. have been very involved in discussions about the assessment center. The assessment center is really designed to serve those first-time nonviolent offenders, mm-hmm. divert them from the juvenile court system, try to address their underlying issues so there's never a second encounter with law enforcement.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm.
The detention center, of course, is really focused on those more serious juvenile offenders who've committed violent crimes and so on. Mm-hmm. So they go hand in hand, but they're serving different populations, mm-hmm. really.
But Sheriff, at the same time, a lot of people will say the answer, though, is not just locking up young people. What are some of the other solutions, though?
Well, I think you're absolutely right, not locking up. Mm. You know, we can't arrest our way out of this problem.
Right.
But partnerships, talking with the community. Alex, I'm out a lot, and I talk to a lot of people. And, you know, you encourage parents to be parents. You know, you're not your child's friend. You listen to what your child is saying. A lot of times, if we just sit down with dinner together, and just listen as a parent, your kid will tell you what's going on out
That's
there.
Right.
And then you start trying to, with the assessment center, that will be a place to go. Parents that don't have all the resources that they need, it could be a single parent home. They can go to that assessment center, find some of the resources that they need to help getting mentors involved in that child's
life. The new UPC, it's only a couple of years old, the Universal Parenting Center, where some of those skills and resources, you know, are there. Real quickly, to what do you attribute the drop in other crime? Is it data-driven policing? Is it, I mean...
Well, I could probably cite six or eight things, but we don't have time for that. But let me mention two that I think have had a significant impact on our violent crime rate. Number one is a commitment by the U.S. Attorney's Office and the DA's Office to vigorously prosecute gun crimes. And I do think that's having an impact, and I think word is getting out to the street level that there is a price to pay for committing a gun crime. Mm. Number two is data-driven policing, smart data-driven policing by local law enforcement, the Memphis Police Department and the Sheriff's Office, making sure they're putting their resources in places to have the maximum impact on violent crime in particular.
All right.
Those two things, I think, are having a very positive impact.
Awesome.
Well, we have you here also, Sheriff, wanted to ask you about the reevaluation of hundreds of your deputies and a process that involved an unlicensed director.
Yes.
Where do we stand with that? How should this be perceived as a major blow, or how do you view it?
Well, we hope it is not going to be a major blow. We started to retest our officers Fridays and on Tuesdays. The Post Commission has given us to April the 19th to have it completed. We will be completed by sometime about mid-February. We're retesting about 214 officers. We're hoping that we don't lose a one, but we're in that process now of retesting.
And the search for the 85-year-old woman who has Alzheimer's, Pandora Duckett. What's the latest on the search for her?
Well, as I was on my way down to do your show, talked with the command post this morning. We're taking recruits out of class to help search. We're doing all we can do to find her. We're using absolutely all the resources. The Memphis Police Department wing unit, the helicopters are up for us, and we've talked to all of the municipalities around and got her picture out.
You guys are doing a tremendous job,
and we thank you for getting it out to the public. So hopefully we're going to find her. It was awfully cold last night, but we're still in rescue mode right now.
Very good.
Thank you very much.
Bill Gibbons, thank you very much as well.
Appreciate your work.
Thank you.
Good information this morning for sure.